is a live presentation of CBC Sports.
Of last season serve as a prelude to the return of Canada's 63-year-old tradition. Saturday night hockey broadcasts. The trucks rolled into the Forum in Montreal, the Pacific Coliseum in Vancouver, and Maple Leaf Gardens, Toronto. Yesterday, all the technical production people were gathered together, tried to remember where to plug everything in, managed to do just that, so we're on the air, ready for lights, action, camera, and the face-off. Thanksgiving weekend, coast to coast in Canada. We're thankful to be back. There's the scene live at Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto outside, and we'll bring you inside and say thankful to be back and thankful that you're back to join us on the home of the champions, CBC Sports. And we'll also, of course, be live from the home of the Stanley Cup champions, the Forum in Montreal, momentarily. Good evening and welcome to our season premiere of Molson Hockey Night in Canada on CBC and at the Gardens in Toronto. I am Ron McLean. Over the years, thanks to Foster Hewitt and Danny Gallivan, Dave Hodge, Ward Cornell, this program's had the chance to be a trailblazer, and it's also left a blazer trail. Case in point, I got here in 86, and this is the jacket we wore then. Randy, you zoom in on that beautiful baby blue. Gee, we loved that jacket from 70 to 86, I think 88, I guess we wore that. Then we decided to change our colors after the Seoul Olympics. Hockey Night and CBC, we got together, had a uniform look. It was a royal blue jacket. Not that Grapes loved any of these, but we had that for 4 years. Deepened the color, tried to make it look like that. Now it's 1993, and well, this is us, the new look for CBC Sports. You'll see a lot of little twists, graphic looks, the change, and our fashion mogul, Don, will be along to give his assessment tonight in the Coach's Corner. As you know, the NHL has two new outfits in Anaheim and Florida. The Ducks were beaten last night by Detroit in their home opener, but what a show. We'll touch on that in after 40 minutes. Florida opens at home on Tuesday against Pittsburgh. Do you know who is where? Well, here's the test. There are two conferences, new names all around. The Eastern has 14 teams in the Atlantic Division. Tampa and Florida are playing tonight at the Thunderdome in St. Pete's. That'll be a new NHL record crowd. The former record was 21-19. It's at least 24,000 on hand, and we'll get an exact figure as the night moves along. Remember, eight teams from the conference get into the playoffs and they play 1-8. Likely five teams out of the Northeast Division will make it. Look at the strength with the champions, Quebec, Boston, Buffalo, and the Pittsburgh Penguins all playing there. 12 teams comprise the Western Conference in the Central Division. The new looks are in Dallas, where the Stars have moved from Minnesota, and the Winnipeg Jets make this a highly competitive six-um. Likely five teams again to make the playoffs out of here, although Edmonton 2-0 looks to be a threat with LA, Vancouver, and Calgary in the Pacific Division, along with San Jose and the new Mighty Ducks of Anaheim. Great feel this evening. Everything's upbeat, but one little bit of concern, and that concerns the officials. They're now in their negotiations with the NHL looking for a new contract. They say if they don't get a new deal, November the 15th, they'll walk out. A report at La Presse in Montreal today says they'll hold workouts for trainees. That'll be the 4th, 5th, and 6th of November. The league is offering the officials 10% across the board. They're not happy with that, nor are they happy with the pension agreement. Last year, 51 officials, the league put in just over $300,000, and Gil Stein Ryan, as an example, has $1.8 million in his buyout over the next 3 years, and then $250,000 per annum after that. So they're looking at these things and aren't too happy. We'll examine that tone in after 40 minutes in our second intermission tonight. Well, to the games at hand. At the Forum in Montreal, the Stanley Cup champions will roll against the Buffalo Sabres. To check out the action at the Forum and see what's new with Buffalo and Montreal, let's go now to the Forum and Scott Russell.
Ron, the recent past provides a glimpse into the immediate future for Montreal. A 24th Cup banner sparks memories of a springtime of excellence. In this city where hockey's heartbeat is so strong, one victory creates great expectations for another, and the demands on the Canadiens are endless. For Buffalo, there is trepidation for the new campaign, understandable in light of postseason casualties. Alexander Mogilny's crumpled leg is still not fully repaired. He is not in the lineup tonight. Captain and team leader Pat LaFontaine is, although he missed much of the preseason, still hurting from the postseason. The Sabres need both razor sharp if they are to contend. And so now they become old rivals in a brand new division. The first of five meetings between the Canadiens and Sabres in the Northeast. Both coaches, Jacques Demers and John Muckler, say this could be the toughest division in hockey with the addition of the Pittsburgh Penguins. Additions to the lineups tonight, not many changes for the Canadiens. Pierre Sevigny, a left winger, however, is getting a regular turn. He's a grinder. Craig Simpson will provide Buffalo with strong scoring punch and give Dale Hawerchuk a talented winger to work with. Chris Cuthbert and Dick Irvin are the partnership in the booth tonight. There they are, high above center ice here at the Montreal Forum. Canadiens and Sabres played seven games last year. Montreal won 5, Buffalo 2. With that in mind, let's head back to Toronto and Ron McLean.
Okay, Scott, the story here was 5-1-1 for Chicago last year in the regular season, but they only outscored the Leafs 23-17. Great goalie battles between Felix Potvin and Eddie Belfour. Calgary dominated Vancouver last year in the regular season. 5-1-1, the totals there. To get the story on the Calgary Flames and Vancouver, both unbeaten, let's go to Ken Daniels.
Thank you, Ron, and welcome to beautiful BC and the Great Pacific Coliseum. So great, in fact, they named a division after it. And inside the Coliseum, moments from now, they will recognize a banner season in which Vancouver finished first in the Smythe Division. In fact, the Vancouver Canucks have finished first in the Smythe Division the last 2 years, and both years they lost out in the division final of the playoffs. The Calgary Flames finished second to Vancouver last year, but they were out first round. So a couple of teams who look to improve on postseason finishes made very few offseason changes. Yesterday, the Vancouver Canucks gathered to hold court, so to speak, for their team's photo. Perhaps their slogan could be, their defense never rests. It's been great. And offensively, they're led again by Pavel Bure, holds or shares 14 club records. A scan of Calgary's bench brings some new faces, but Dave King still looking to the veterans to carry the load. Guys like Al MacInnis and Gary Roberts, who missed much of last season due to injury. And how about Joe Nieuwendyk, the captain, a 38-goal season last year, looking to hit 50 again like he did his first 2 years. And the men who will call the goals tonight at the Pacific Coliseum, Steve Armitage and John Garrett. So from the Pacific Coast, where it's an all-Pacific division matchup, we send you back to the East in a Central Division battle.
And the distribution of the game can at Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto, the Leafs and the Blackhawks to Ontario and the Atlantic provinces, as described by Bob Cole and Harry Neal in the broadcast booth. And ringside with me now, Don Cherry.
I tell you, it looks pretty good. Don Cherry, that's it, eh? I tell you,
you're on.
The conferences and the divisions is dynamite this year. I'll tell you, boy, we're going to have, anybody gets an injury, anybody falters, there's nobody going to be around Christmas. They're going to float because the divisions are set up. You float for a little while now, you could be out of the playoff. The Leafs, three guys, Andrew Chuck, Potvin, and you got to have Gilmore in there. One of those guys gets hurt, you're in deep trouble. I don't like their schedule. They've got a tough schedule. And I'll tell you something, boy, we're in for a great year.
Think the Leafs will be better than 99 points, Don?
No, they will not make 99 points. They don't have Tampa to kick around anymore, but they're going to make the playoffs, and here comes Chicago, and we got to get out of here.
Time to get to the opening faceoff. We'll have that for you in just a moment. Sound the tom-toms. Hockey season's back on Molson Hockey Night in Canada on CBC.
Oh, the good old hockey game is the best game you can name. And the best game you can name is the good old hockey game. Oh, the good old hockey game is the best game you can name. And the best game you can name is the good old hockey game.